That was just an intro to make this video look good. In this video, I will show you a documentation of me drawing on my car with a permanent marker, which you can find on Instagram, many cars that have hashtag Sharpie car. I bought the car a few weeks back and I wasn't completely satisfied with the color and I wanted to do some sort of creative change to it. I wanted my car to be different. I originally wanted to plastidip the car so I can draw on the whole bonnet, but that was an epic fail.
I think I've sprayed a little bit too much, so you can see it's all dripping down. I have to peel this whole thing off and do it all over again.
Then confronted with a tight budget, I was only able to buy a certain amount of clear film, which can only cover about 1/3 of the bonnet. So that's why I had to rethink my design, and now it's the two racing stripes you see on the bonnet now. Why didn't I draw directly on the car? It's because I wanted to protect the paint, and it is possible that I will be selling the car in the future, and I'm not sure the future buyer will like my drawings. Or I hope he or she does. So using a non-permanent method is a good idea for me. This is the process of me drawing on my car, making mistakes, and I hope you can get something out of it. Don't make the mistakes I have made, and be smart. I really hope this video will benefit people who are planning to draw on hard materials with permanent markers. I would say prep work is very important if you want the artwork to last. I didn't plan what I wanted to draw, though the night before I did my drawing, I did go online and get inspiration from other artists. But most of the time I just drew whatever came to my mind. So it was purely just, I guess, intuition. So that's what makes this piece of artwork unique, because it's what I was thinking at that time. I did plan to draw the Taipei 101 and the Auckland Sky Tower though, because They are two very significant buildings from the two places, and Taiwan and New Zealand, well, they're both very important places for me. My doodles are mostly inspired by Aboriginal shapes, such as the Taiwanese Aboriginal tribe patterns and the New Zealand Māori patterns. Like when I go to the marae, I can just see all these beautiful, like something like tamako, and they are very inspiring. So it's not authentically those patterns, but I did add a bit of a twist to it. What will be my next project? Hopefully I'll be able to draw on my laptop, and in the near future I'm hoping I can get another car, which in my mind right now is the Nissan 350 GT, or in the US they would call it the Infiniti G35. It's just a car that I think will look awesome with doodles on it, and I'm hoping to get one big stripe down the middle and probably two by the sides, some more by the mirrors, and probably a little bit at the back. I'm not sure. I'm still trying to get that car. It's just something I hope I can follow up. And there's just something so beautiful about people sharing their experiences and other people can learn from them. And I really appreciate that. So I hope after you've watched this video, you can get something out of it, make it beneficial, make it into something more beautiful. I hope to inspire you to do something different, to do something creative as well.